Good morning, everyone. Today is Sunday, November 28th, and I'm out here on my trap line. And I got a nice red fox, a big male. I caught this in a trench set, step down dirt hole. With some mouse bait I made, and Dunlap's Hellfire, and Hoosier Trappers Vixen Nixon, and a little bit of urine. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Wild About Being Outdoors. This is such a lovely sight. I caught my second coyote ever here in Maryland on the produce farm that I've been trapping on for years. Wow. Awesome. It's the Monday after Thanksgiving, and my third set I come to, I have this beautiful coyote. Wow. Awesome. Totally awesome. Wow, I'm so glad. I'm overly happy right now. I don't know what to say. It's a coyote. I don't expect to catch them here. I do see tracks of them, but I don't get them on my trail cams, and I have like six of them going here most of the time. But well, I want to dispatch this fella. This is my second one at this set, and I caught it in a RJ set, step down dirt hole. With my 911 bait, I know it's getting old me saying that, but I'm just being honest with yous. And I put in Holder Baker's long distance call. I put some of that in, and I put in Death Scent from Ed Snyder Trapline Products. That stuff really works. That I wouldn't trap without it. Yeah. All right. Well. Yeah, what do you got to say? Yeah. All right, well, I'm gonna dispatch this fella. All right, everyone, I'm here at this new farm, approximately 300 acres, like just a little bit of shy of 300. And I'm trapping in sections here. It's a little bit too much. For me, in my condition of walking. But I set some DPs yesterday, and man, did I get two babies. They had to be just born. Yeah. And they're definitely gonna get free passes. But hopefully I catch their mother and father and brothers, big brothers. These guys are definitely newborns. Yeah, I put four of them here, right here in this little section right here. He told me that He knows there's a lot of coon in these woods. They haven't been trapped for years. And I just happened to get lucky and get a big property for myself. So, all right. I'm going to release these guys. And I'm going to look at my other sets to see if I have anything. If so, I'll get back to you. If not, I'll see you on Wednesday morning. All right, everyone. Take care. Good morning. Well, I'm out here checking my trap line. It's December 1st, 2021. And I got another red fox. A nice big one. Nice big male. And in this set, I had 911 bait, death scent, and moonshot. And I didn't touch it up at all since the last time I caught something here. That was the last time that I touched it. I drive by it every day. I don't get out of my truck at my sights. If I don't see nothing, I keep on going. And it sat for like 4 days, 5 days without being touched. Nice big old one. Dark red. Awesome. Well, that's two here for this set. And I caught two over there, but this one hasn't been really being touched since the second day. Of me setting. I may have to freshen up the scent in the bait hole, but awesome day. First thing this morning, 26 degrees. Yeah, you want to bark. All right, everyone. Well, I'm going to take care of this guy and move on down the line. Hopefully, I have more to show you. Good morning, everyone. Today is December 2nd. And I'm on my trap line. And the first sets I come to, I have a red fox. The same spot as the one that I caught yesterday morning. That's the fourth one out of that set. And yesterday I didn't video it, but I had a red fox with bad mange, real bad. That's a poor thing to have. But I dispatched them and then put them in a trash bag and threw them in the dumpster here, because I went to other animals to get in contact with it. Well, I'm at my other set where I caught one yesterday. No, Monday. Sorry. This is my third one now at this set. And this was the RJ set, Trent set. And this one's a pretty one. Has a white back foot. Man, I never seen that before. Wow. Yeah. 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 You're a pretty guy. You might have to go to the taxidermist with me. With my coyote. Yeah. Well, good morning, everyone. Welcome to Wild About Being Outdoors. December 3rd. This is a beautiful morning. I got two coyotes at the same time. My first double. I cannot believe this. Man, listen to these song dogs. Oh my God, I'm happy. Oh my God, thank you, God. Thank you. Wow. Beautiful looking dogs. They're gonna look nice being tanned. Awesome. This one down here, I had 911 bait down here with death scent. And this one up here, I had Border Patrol, I think. It was something new. I got in the mail. I'm sorry. I'll put it up. I'll let you know what it is. Guy trapping company asked me if I would like to try their products. And I did. And this is the first time I used it in this set. And I used The Last Sunset, I think it is, from Ed Snyder, Kansas Trapline Products. And that one down there, I just used a little bit of urine. Some of the turkey feathers that you can see there. And like I said, death scent and my 911. I decided this year I'm not gonna put a lot of scents out. I'm just gonna use one or two percent, and that is it. And it's really been working out. Can you sing for me? Come on. All right, everyone. Well, I had to get, I couldn't believe this when I pulled up. I don't want to sound like a broken record, but I am a happy person today. One happy trapper. All right, everyone. Thanks for watching. All right, everyone, I just wanted to show you what I was using in the dirt holes. There's death scent, and that's my 911. And here, like I said, Border Patrol, Ozark Mountain Lures, and Last Stance from Kansas Trapline. If you don't use those three lures, give them a call and get some of their bait and lure. You can't go wrong with anything from Kansas Trapline products. Every lure I really use works good for me. And like I said, that was the first time I used the Ozark Mountain Lures, Border Patrol. It's a bobcat-based predator bait. And then my 911 has a lot of good ingredients, oils, and it's been doing really good for me for the last 3 years. All right, everyone. And this is what my finished set looked like up top here with Border Patrol, just a little bit on the end of a butter knife, actually. And Last Dance on that piece of wood there. And then down here, I went, and here's my finished set. There was a cow jawbone here that I had yesterday. Threw some turkey feathers down in the dirt hole, and that's it. I put 911, very little, only actually just the juice down the hole, and then death scent underneath that jawbone on the top lip. And this is exactly the same way it was without being tore up yesterday. Well, yeah, yesterday. All right, everyone, thanks for watching. I'm gonna move on down the line. Hopefully I have more to show you. Take care. All right, everyone, here I'm checking my DP traps, and they might be dog proof, but they definitely ain't cat proof. I can't believe this. A cat. Freaking sucks. I hate this. But I gotta release this. But I just thought I'd show yous. They might be dog proof traps, but they're not cat proof. All right, everyone, I just thought I'd show you that.